Hey, how are you guys?
Good. How are you doing?
Good.
Are you in your house in Arizona?
Yes, I am.
God, you know, it's funny. People sure made a big deal over this. Like, oh, she bought a house for him. It's like, so
like,
what?
Like nobody ever buys her homes.
I know.
Did you write a check for that house?
Yeah, I did.
Wasn't that cool?
Yeah, it was cool.
I mean,
dancing with the stars worth it.
I know. That's awesome.
Absolutely.
Hey, listen, we got a story yesterday, and I'm sure you've already heard about, and it's amazing how information just travels at the speed of light these days.
Or disinformation.
Or disinformation. Story is Bristol Palin to change Tripp's last name from Johnson to Palin. And you made an agreement with Levi that he won't have to pay child support anymore if you change his last name to Palin. Is there any truth to that at all?
No, unfortunately, it is not true.
I like how you say it.
It sounds like a true story, though. That's like one of the stories out there that, like, at least it sounds true.
Right.
It's somewhat plausible.
Well, you can, you can look at it from both angles and go, oh, that makes sense. I mean, you look at it from your standpoint, having the last name Palin, I don't think is a bad thing these days. And then you can see it from his point where he's like, well, monetarily, I'm off the hook for the next, 17 years. Doesn't matter to me. So I guess you could see how that's plausible. Had you even considered doing that?
Yeah, I've asked Levi to do it many different times, just get it out of the way, just sign over his parental rights, but I don't know if he will or if he wants to right now.
Mm-hmm. Have you asked him about that?
Have I asked him to change Tripp's last name?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course.
Oh, yeah. And what was his reaction?
I don't remember. It was like 2 years ago. But.
Oh, I gotcha. Okay. All right. So it's been a while since you've discussed it with him.
Yeah.
Oh, now would you be, if he were to say, all right, I'm putting words in his mouth. For all I know, he's dead set against it and he would never, ever have that happen. That's his boy and that's his legacy. And I understand that. And I mean, Tripp is just a beautiful child. And I would guess that that's probably where he's standing on this issue. But would you be agreeable to say, look, I'm independent. I make my own money. I don't need your child support. So if you agree to that, I'll let you off the hook. Would you do that?
Yeah, of course. I've asked him to do that many times. Just say, hey, let's just avoid this custody case that's been ongoing since Tripp was born. Yeah. Just get it over with. Just sign over your rights. And he's always going to be your son. You can see him whenever you want to. But he just doesn't want to sign him over just because it looks bad on paper.
Sure. I got you. How often does Levi see Tripp?
Since Dancing with the Stars, he's seen him at the most 3 times.
And does he spend like a weekend or?
No, it's like 4 hours, I think.
Okay. Now,
it's unfortunate for Tripp, but.
This story also mentioned a boyfriend that you have.
Oh, are you seeing somebody?
Is there someone in your life?
Are you guys getting personal with me, really?
You know, we never ask you these questions.
Really?
And we're just curious because,
you don't have to answer if you don't
want. You could say, cool. I plead the fifth or whatever. But the only problem is when you do that, everyone inserts their own answer.
Right. But,
It's better just to say, yeah, you know what? I'm seeing a guy and he's really great and Tripp loves him and we're having a good time and we're really good friends. Let's go with that.
And?
Yeah, we can go with that.
All right. Go with that. And it's none of anybody's business.
Absolutely. None of your damn business. Right?
There you go. Well, good for you. As long as you're happy, that's great.
Yeah. Are you happy?
Yeah, I'm thrilled. I love the town that I live in. I love my house. Tripp's happy. He's healthy. Everything's great.
That's Is there any talk about some other Palins moving to Arizona?
I have no idea.
You don't know?
Mm-mm.
All right. So what's next for you? What are you doing now? Just kind of relaxing a little bit, taking it easy?
Yeah, I'm working on a few different projects, but I have that interview that I was telling you about. With
right,
the
radio
station
here. Yeah, yes. We understand you got a legitimate offer to do a morning show, to go on some morning show. Now, are you in, what town are you in?
I'm in Maricopa.
Okay, Maricopa. So how far is the radio station from your house?
I think it's like 30 minutes. It's in Phoenix.
That's Phoenix is cool. That's Sheriff Joe Arpaio's county, isn't it? Maricopa?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's a cool guy.
Did you say you have an interview with him?
not an interview. I'm just going to meet with them to see if it's actually legitimate
right.
and to see if I like the guy that I would be on air with.
I gotcha. Well, cool. Cool. Tell him, you know what, just say, look, I've done morning radio in Alaska. I've been on the Bob and Mark show hundreds of times.
Yeah, all you got to do is say, yeah, I'll do it, but it's got to be the Bob and Mark show featuring Bristol Palin. Right
really?
There in Phoenix. No, right. Really, it's nice there, and we're cold.
Yeah. tell him you'd rather do a mid-morning show.
There you go.
Right?
There you go.
You know, you don't feel like getting up that early, because that, I got to tell you, Bristol, I love my job.
Oh, yeah.
But getting up at the butt crack of dawn.
No.
Sucks.
Yeah. But it's fun.
Yeah. But do you hear what the guy has to say, right?
Yeah. Listen to what he
says. Yeah, definitely.
Well, good for you. Okay. Golly. Bristol Palin getting into radio. You're a multi threat.
You're doing it,
BP. You are doing it. We're proud of you. Keep on keeping
Absolutely.
On, okay?
Absolutely.
We appreciate you chatting with us this morning, okay?
Yes.
Have a good day. Bye, Bristol.
Bye.
All right, that's Bristol Palin.